Hi, I'm Kurt David, host of the show From Glory Days. Please join me and watch the stories of Hall of Fame, All-Star, World Champion, and former professional athletes as they've transitioned from the pinnacle of their pro sports careers back to normal, everyday lives. Today's guest was an athletic standout at Detroit Catholic Central High School. At 18 years of age, he became a first-round draft pick by the California Angels. Early in his career, his pitches were often clocked at over 100 miles per hour, and his 21-year tenure in Major League Baseball found him sporting uniforms with the Angels, Red Sox, Rangers, Mets, Tigers, and the Yankees. You can now find his former pitcher throwing fireballs from the pulpit as a zealot for his faith and unashamed to pitch the good news. Today's guest, Frank Tanana. When we come back, you'll hear Frank's secret to being married for over 35 years.
From Glory Days, with your host, Kurt David.
Professional athletes give everything to win the game. After their glory days, most professional athletes want to give back to their communities. United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. With a remarkable background and impressive stats, Great Lakes Capital Fund is the perfect teammate capable of making big things happen. With this team, everyone wins.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
Hi, I'm Kurt David, joined by my guest, Frank Tanana. Frank, great having you on the show here.
Kurt, good to be here, man.
So baseball, you know, obviously has been a huge part of your life, but let's back up even before that. You were growing up, you went to Detroit Catholic Central High School, many different sports, actually, lots of talent in all the different sports.
Well, only one other, baseball and basketball. Mm-hmm. Kurt really was, were my two, my father was a great athlete, loved sports, any kind of sports, you know, growing up as a kid. But when I got to high school, just really focused on baseball and basketball, those two.
And you're actually looking at possibly a basketball scholarship, or actually you were heading that direction.
I was going to Duke University on a basketball scholarship. They had agreed to let me play baseball if I came to their school. So I said, okay, you know, I'd like to do both. If I go to college, my hopes and dreams were always, though, to, you know, play baseball and be a pro.
What was the preference for you? Why baseball over basketball?
I was just better at it. Mm. I was a good basketball player, but I'd had success in every league that I ever played in as a baseball pitcher in particular.
Mm-hmm. So you knew that your talents were better in that direction. Like you said, if you go to the next level, that, you know, getting at Duke isn't anything to sneeze at, though, as a basketball scholarship, but you knew that baseball was going to be the one that might take you to the next level, is what you said.
It's where my heart was.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? You like to play them, but I really was excited to, you know, try my hand at pitching.
And so Fullerton's, how'd you end up with Fullerton down here? You ended up out there in California for a little bit, right? Just for a minute?
It was about a minute.
Yeah.
Yeah, about a semester.
Okay.
I just thought I'd try out some schooling.
So how did that happen? Instead of Duke, you went out to California State, correct, in Fullerton?
Well, I actually, no, Kurt, I signed right out of high school and played some minor league ball. And the only thing that Fullerton was, when I got to the big leagues, I wondered, you know, would schooling. So I gave it a semester of a try is why I went there, and realized that wasn't so much for me. So
it wasn't for you
stuck,
at that point.
Stuck to baseball.
Yeah, you found that out. And so California Angels, you know, you get picked up, signed by the California Angels. Let's talk about those early years. What did you find out early on as a pro athlete?
Well, you know, early on I found out that, you know, I quickly made the all-star teams and just shot real quick to the top of my profession. By the time I was 24 years of age, Kurt, I'd almost won 100 games in the big leagues. Sadly, they had designated hitter came in, and I didn't get the bat. So that bothered me, but, you know, it's the way it was. But
were you
pitching
batting pretty
wise,
good? I mean, you were batting pretty good.
I was a good, felt like, you know, as an athlete, I could hit.
Mm-hmm.
And so that, it would have been a lot more fun being able to swing the bat, but I couldn't. But that was all right. Teammates with Nolan Ryan with the California Angels. Mm-hmm. We weren't that good at the start, but got better as I stayed with them.
Mm-hmm. In fact, you kept getting better as well, you know, being clocked at 100 miles an hour, over 100 miles an hour at sometimes early on in your career.
Well, I don't know where that was, but as far as clocking, because we really didn't use the clock very much, mm-hmm. Kurt, back then. I'm sure I was close, but never threw as consistently hard as Nolan did.
Mm-hmm. Gave you somebody to shoot for, right?
Yeah, it was a great combination.
Yeah, so let's talk about that. So you were in California. How did you end up here in Detroit? There was actually some journeys along the way, wasn't there?
There was.
21 years, lots of changes that occurred.
I hurt my arm in 1977. Mm-hmm. And took me a while to get back. Never got cut on. I had no surgeries, but thought, because this was kind of my second pretty serious arm injury, so decided to change my style of pitching from a hard thrower to a finesse mm-hmm. pitcher. And, you know, things didn't work out. California had a change of management. We didn't quite see eye to eye. And, you know, stuff happens, mm-hmm. as you know, with relationships. So they went ahead and traded me to Boston. And I lasted 1 year in Boston, threw okay, but didn't have a good record, mm-hmm. was at the end of a contract. They didn't want to renew it. So then I'm free agent, and then they go ahead and I signed with Texas Rangers. Mm-hmm. And then boom, after about 3.5 years with them, I was at the bottom, wasn't pitching. I lost 19 games with Texas. Mm-hmm. Then a couple years later, I won 15, so I was on the upswing. Mm-hmm. But then they had a change of manager. And when a change of manager comes, if you're a veteran player and you're not a main clog, you're gone. They're going to, because that's a voice in the clubhouse. Yeah, that's a voice in the clubhouse. They want their own guys, and it's understood. Mm-hmm. It's the way it happens. So then I got a chance to, Milt Wilcox got hurt with the Tigers. Mm-hmm. They were world champs the year before.
84, so you came in 85.
I come in 85 because Milt went down and they needed a pitcher. And so probably for a couple of bats and a dozen balls, they were able to get me from the Texas Rangers.
For a song.
It was a song, less than a song, a couple of chords, I think, basically.
You end up here in Detroit, had some good years here as well. I mean, like you said, your baseball career was kind of on the upswing at that point, though, still.
It was. Yeah, it was back. I mean, I'd been to the top of the mm-hmm. mountain, down to the valley, and now we were climbing back up. And got to be back to my hometown team.
How special was that, playing back here in Detroit?
Well, it was the best. I mean, a boyhood dream, you can imagine, wearing that English D. First game back, Kurt, I'm pitching against the Yankees. Shut them out 2-0. Mm. So that was an instant rapport with my teammates, and was able for the next 7 years to play with the Tigers.
Yeah, you know, at that point, it was definitely a special moment for you.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, we need to take a break right now, but when I come back, we're going to have Frank Tanana share his favorite baseball ritual.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Great Lakes Capital Fund has built a game plan to provide a legendary kind of impact that will facilitate affordable housing to those in need and help build and better the communities that surround them. Together, the United Athletes Foundation and the housing and development experts at Great Lakes Capital Fund have the power of connecting professional athletes' vision, voice, and drive with asset management and strength. With this team, everyone wins.
Big statements are made with actions, not words. Go to the guys that work as hard as you do. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer on US 23, exit 149 in Whitmore Lake. The 24,000 square foot facility performs all service applications on tractors and trailers, light duty, heavy duty, single axle, multi-axle, dump trailers, and walking floors. No job is too big or too small. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer, 734-995-9600. Nowatzky Truck and Trailer. We do it right the first time.
Do you need a proven winner? Do you want to build a better team, create stronger leaders, and face change like a champion? Kurt David works with highly successful individuals, organizations, and businesses that at times face challenges with leadership, change, and developing passion. Go to KurtDavid.com and allow Kurt the opportunity to work with you.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
I'm Kurt David, back with my guest, Frank Tanana. Frank, every athlete seems to have their own ritual or routine that they do. What was your favorite routine, especially as a pitcher? I mean, you see these guys on the mound, they got all sorts of little nuances or something. What was some of yours or one of yours that you can recall?
Well, you know, the ritual started just, you know, for a starting pitcher, you got 35 maybe days where you're on, you know. So my wife understood it. People around me understood it. My ritual, I would really just go inside.
What do you mean by that? Just well, in your cave, so to speak.
I wasn't real pleasant to be around. I wasn't sociable, and I'm pretty an outgoing guy, and I liked that. But when it was game time, I was really closed. I'd have the same meal, you know, before I pitched when I was at home. I'm a steak and potatoes guy, so I would load up on that, maybe some pasta, you know, get to the ballpark, and I mean, I'm, you know, I'm not, don't talk
game
to
face.
Me. Yeah,
yeah,
I'm not looking to, you know, I just, and
make
guys knew it. Yeah, I knew it. I'm in, I'm thinking about the hitters. I'm warming up a certain way. I'm stretching at a certain time. I'm going over to hitters at a certain time. You know, I've got this clockwork going because when that bell rang, I'm on. I've got nothing else to concentrate on, really, that day. And it was an all-consuming moment where, because as a starting pitcher, like I said, I've only got 35 of those out of 365 days where I need every ounce of concentrated power and physical energy to perform.
And you did that for 21 years.
Yes.
How do you sustain that level for 21 years? That's amazing. I mean, that's amazing for somebody to have that long of a career, professional career, for any sport, but baseball especially.
Well, it is, especially through the ups and downs, the aches and pains of when you're using your arm as your livelihood in an unnatural motion as throwing is with such force. I got stretch marks, Kurt, you know, on the back of my arm from throwing and stretching it out. And again, you just, you know, you develop the habits, you develop the patterns, and you're very fortunate, let's put it that way, that the arm lasted. Some blow out sooner, some last longer. I was fortunate enough to where my arm hung in there, and my legs, you know, for a pitcher, using your legs and body, and health was able to just stay that way. But it was such a joy. It was so much fun. You know, they were going to have to rip the uniform off of me. So I was going to make sure I did it
You
somehow.
Did have transition. I mean, you changed, like you said, about halfway through that career, you had to change what type of pitcher you were. You changed what style you were. So you had that change going on. At what point did you start realizing towards the end that it was really going to change for you? What point? What was that like? How did that happen for you?
Well, you know, I'm 40 years of age. And, you know, you see around you that there are many 40-year-olds.
Guys are 20s, yeah.
Yeah, there are many 40-year-olds in big league baseball. So, and I knew from a physical standpoint, you know, the stuff, my speed, my velocity, though I felt I was still effective. And then also, though, from a family standpoint, Kurt, you know, my wife looked at me and said, we got four daughters growing up. You know, I got three. One's about to be a teenager. Twins just behind her. And as, you know, I'm traveling 3 months out of the year, I'm away from them physically, I'm gone. So Kat's got to be both mom and dad. And so we had reached a point where determined amongst ourselves that this was going to be one more year that I would play, you know, baseball. But as it turned out, there were no more years because in that spring of 1993 or 94, I should say, I got released from the California Angels and my career was over.
No chance the phone got quiet. I mean, that's what athletes talk about, is there's no calls, there's nobody saying, hey, we need you, or come on in.
Yeah, I came home and I told Kath, I said, honey, if this phone doesn't ring in 24 hours, you know, it's not going to ring, and you've got me.
So you set that, you set a goal saying, okay, some guys hang on for years. I mean, really. So what prevented you from doing that?
Well, I think being financially secure, to the point where, you know, we were fine in that regard. My priorities had changed through the course of even halfway through my career, where baseball wasn't king.
Wasn't
it wasn't
important
God.
To
it wasn't my top priority. So because of that, to see the transition coming wasn't scary.
Now you mentioned about the finances. Athletes take up to a 90% pay cut when they're done playing. Many of them bankrupt, you know, troubles, all sorts of things. What prevented that from happening to you?
Well, I had wonderfully, again, began to, I had a company that was taking good care of my finances. I put it, I let the Bible be my guide as to how I was going to spend my money, save my money, give my money, use my money. And because of that, Kurt, I was wise in what the Lord, you know, wanted me to do with the funds that he'd provided for me. So because of that, you know, I didn't go off on these wild ventures. I didn't have to become rich. I already was. You know, it's just now a matter of putting to use what God gave me. Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
And you became a good steward of the money as well.
Right.
Yeah, boy, so that was great. And as a result, it made your transition that much easier.
It did.
Yeah. Well, we're going to take a quick break, but when we come back from commercial here, we're going to hear Frank's new pitch when we return.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Great Lakes Capital Fund and the United Athletes Foundation have built a game plan that will create stable and sustainable communities that include affordable housing and economic development opportunities. The United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. And Great Lakes Capital Fund has a superior track record in raising capital and managing communities they invest in. Together, they raise capital to invest in the future. With this team, everyone wins.
Genosco Development Company is a real estate development firm specializing in the creation and preservation of quality housing. GDC, through its subsidiaries and joint ventures, engages in the acquisition, development, ownership, and operational oversight of multifamily communities.
GDC aligns itself with a team of experts that believes every property should serve as an economic and social catalyst to the community.
GDC communities are known for their careful planning, attention to detail, and respect for the environment.
Join me, Diana Lewis, and support Detroit Rescue Mission Ministries, which provides emergency shelter, substance abuse counseling, job training, transitional housing, and eventually to those who qualify, a permanent home so they can lead healthy, independent lives. Among those in need, military veterans, women with young children, and families. Please call the number on your screen or go online to drmm.org and donate now.
We all experience financial bumps in the road. It's called life. And when financial challenges pop up, LOC team members are here. We specialize in debt relief strategies for our members. With lower fees and better loan rates, you'll realize the best place to do all your banking is at LOC Federal Credit Union. It's time to own your money. Visit us on the web or call to learn more.
Welcome to LOC Federal Credit Union. How can we help?
Yep, with Xfinity Internet, your family can use all their devices at once. Works anywhere in the house, even the garage.
Max, what's going on?
We're doing a tech startup. We're streamlining an algorithm.
What's Grandpa doing?
Hi.
Shh, Grandpa, you don't want to be an intern forever.
Sorry, Dad. We have to get back to work. We have a deadline.
We're going public!
The fastest in-home Wi-Fi for your entire family. Sign up for the X1 Triple Play and get double the speed. Only from Xfinity.
I'm Kurt David, joined by my guest, Frank Tanana. Frank, we talked about this transition out of sports and how you had a different attitude about it, that life was different for you at that point as opposed to many professional athletes. For what reason?
Well, you know, it was really exciting. You know, halfway through my career, I got hurt, and my significance was totally wrapped up in baseball.
In baseball. That was your identity.
It was my identity. It's who I was. I then also had a teammate, Lyman Bostock, who got shot and killed. He was 27 years of age. And through that, my injury, Lyman's death, I began to search for really what is life all about. And I wonderfully, the chaplain of the California Angels, John Warehouse, introduced me to the Bible, which I'd never really read, or I'd certainly heard about it and seen it, and I was a religious guy and believed in all of that. But I began to, for myself, pursue the scriptures and read it and do some Bible studies and just came to understand the message, really came to believe that Jesus Christ, who said he was God and who rose from the dead, the whole gospel, the good news of Jesus and why he came, what he's all about, and what it means to a person like me, all of us, what's the meaning? I just came to understand, Kurt.
So what was the meaning? What was the meaning for you at that point in your life?
The meaning for me was either Jesus was who he said he was. He said he's the only way to God, that if you believe in him, you would never die. You'd die physically, but you'd go to be with God forever. His resurrection from the dead was either a reality or it was fiction. And I mean, here Lyman dies, so where'd Lyman go? And so I just began that
questioning
search
things.
And questioning.
Yeah.
But then came to understand, Kurt, that, you know, Christ came to live the perfect life that you and I, because we're sinners and we violate God's commands, can't live. But he lived it and actually was crucified, took my place, took your place, took everyone's place. And that if we placed our faith in him, he promised eternal life.
And that changed you.
And that radically changed me. I invited Christ to come into my life. He began to be the one I lived for. I grabbed the scriptures. I began to follow what the Word of God said. He began to order my life, changed all my relationships with my wife, with my kids, with my teammates. But most important, changed my relationship where I was no longer God. I was no longer king. Jesus Christ was. I laid down my life, followed him, and he has wonderfully put together my life in ways that we don't have enough time to talk about, but it's the most wonderful decision, best decision I ever made.
How did that decision impact your professional baseball playing? Because, you know, you're a pro athlete at that same time. How did that affect that?
Well, it wonderfully affected it, Kurt, because all the distractions that they
pro
were
sports
gone.
Can offer.
Yeah, they were gone, and when I was at the ballpark, I was focused because God says to do your work in an excellent manner. I focused on training harder, being the best pitcher I could be, but also, even better than that, being the best man and teammate I could be. That's where the greatest effect took place. The fact that I was loving my teammates, I was encouraging my teammates, I was cheering them on. I was a great teammate.
You were a changed man.
Because of Christ. Oh, totally changed.
Yeah, so as far as baseball, you know, baseball took you to a different level. And having that platform, how did that help you with being a pro athlete?
Well, again, you know, it's the platform that God's given me, it's been wonderful to use to take the glory that a professional career gives a man. Mm-hmm. And really, it's all because of God. I'm able to now use that platform to persuade or encourage or even tell people just how wonderful Jesus Christ is, and hopefully they go and search out for themselves. You know, because really all we do is believe what others have told us. I just encourage people to read God's Word for themselves so that they're going to make a decision, to make a wise decision. Because there's just a lot of, you know, what is truth? Mm-hmm. You know, Jesus said, I'm the truth. So,
and this is what
I
you
found
do now.
The truth. It's what I do now.
And this is what you do now. You travel, you speak. Let's talk more about that. We're working, you know, Frank Tanana is everywhere. Your churches, pulpits, where is it that you're doing now?
I am just, again, sowing the seed. I'm proclaiming Christ wherever I go. I am not ashamed of Christ. I could care less what other people think. I know what Jesus Christ has done for me, and I know what he can do for anyone who will place their faith in Jesus Christ. He said, I'm the way, the truth, and the life, Kurt, and no one comes to the Father but through me. It's not, you know, it's not popular today because today anything goes. You can all do what you want. But Jesus laid it out. You want to get to heaven, you want to know God, love me, and you'll know God. And so I just, because of what he's done in my life, Kurt, I'm just out there. Here
makes
he is.
Easier.
Here he is. It's all about Jesus. Do what you want with him. But for me and my house, we love Jesus.
And I think you've said, I've heard you speak before in public, and one of the things you said is, I'm an unabashed, unashamed Jesus freak.
Oh, totally. Yeah, I just know that he gave his life for me. No one else has done that. No one else laid it down. Paid my penalty for my sins. My sins deserve death and judgment. Jesus said, you know what? I don't want you to be judged. I'll take your judgment, and you just follow me. And I'm just glad God opened my eyes, and I was able to do that, and have been doing that for now 31 years.
Yeah. We need to take another break, but when we come back, your Facebook question for Frank Tanana.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.
Professional athletes give everything to win the game. After their glory days, most professional athletes want to give back to their communities. United Athletes Foundation helps athletes focus on their visions and support causes that are important to them. With a remarkable background and impressive stats, Great Lakes Capital Fund is the perfect teammate capable of making big things happen. With this team, everyone wins.
I'm Kurt David with my guest, Frank Tanana. Frank, a Facebook question from Chris asked this. Every testimony has its test. What was the biggest test for you?
Well, I think my biggest test for me was, let's say, getting traded to the Tigers, okay? And wanting to be one of the boys. And so, you know, what I did, I failed this test initially. I wanted to be one of the boys. So I went out and drinking and just got, you know, drunk and really violated my testimony as a follower of Jesus Christ. But once you fail, the key is, what do you do next? And I just simply apologized to the guys the next day, told them I'd done wrong, that, you know, they wouldn't be seeing me in the bars anymore, but, you know, we'd be friends and golf and all of that, but that I failed. But then the Lord, through the power of the Spirit, allowed me to, you know, pass that test. Mm. But you're gonna, you know, no, you're not perfect. Mm-hmm. So what do you do when you fail? One of the greatest victories in the test also comes as a man, is all the, you know, the lust and the stuff that's out there that,
especially just, as a pro athlete,
well, just anywhere, yeah. Kurt. That, and God, the test in there is, how do you stay pure? You know, how do you stay faithful to your wife? And I'm just proud to say that I've passed that test.
And you've been married for how many years?
36 years.
36 years now. Yeah. So what is the secret?
Well, the secret is to realize that she's a 10, and all the other she's are not 10s. Mm-hmm. So nobody comes close to her and her beauty. And she's the definition of beauty in my life.
That keeps it for 36 years as a result.
That's it.
Well, Frank, this show is about the transition of professional athletes, but more importantly, we want it to be about transitions in life. What advice would you have for anybody that's going through a change or transition?
Well, I think, Kurt, as I said, you know, life is all about change. The best thing about life is to find your identity, to find someone who doesn't change, and that's Jesus Christ. God is the same today, tomorrow, yesterday. He doesn't change. So what I would suggest for people is to unite yourself with the one who doesn't change, so that as change occurs, he's able to help you navigate and understand the changes that are coming and the changes that, you know, he'll help get you through it.
Great words of wisdom from Frank Tanana. I'm Kurt David, and that wraps up another show. Please join us again next time when we watch the stories of professional athletes unfold from Glory Days.
From Glory Days, presented in part by Genosco Development Company, building a brighter future today.